And now time for weekly show with a passionate India lover, chairman of ITV Gold and Parikh Worldwide Media. Get ready for loving sharing from physician, philanthropist, publisher and India advocate in this week with Padma Shri, Dr. Sudhir Parikh. Namaskar, I'm Ashok Vyas and I'm delighted to be in the presence of Padma Shri Dr. Sudhir Parikh for this show which all of you have appreciated and shared your views, and I take this opportunity once again welcoming you, Dr. Sudhir.
Thank you.
So how was your week? If you look back, you were very active every week participating in many Indian events. Anything that you felt was very exciting?
Well, I mean, the whole last week was Diwali celebration and Happy New Year celebration, and it was a great celebration. It's not only Diwali celebration, or is not only a religious celebration, but it's a way to tell our children or connect them to our culture and heritage, and they should know who we are and where we come from. And I think that's why this celebration is very important.
Absolutely. I think this is a big challenge for all immigrants, whichever country they are in, even especially in America also, though there is so much active and vibrant Indian community, yet however you try, you feel that something is missing. If you try to understand, how would you define, what is it that you miss, you cannot sort of convey to the next generation in terms of...
No, because the next generation is grown up here with a different atmosphere, different surrounding, different peers, different friends. And so there is always something missing or disconnect. And so our role as a parents, we should make sure that they connect. And the only way to connect is you don't have to be ritualistic, but you have to be more kind of, you should be religious, you should be, but not ritualistic. Means you don't have to tell your son or daughter that you sit down and do the homa, or do this, or do that every day, or every other day, or once a week, or once a month. Because that that ritualistic thing will turn them off, because they will not understand why we are doing what we are doing. And the logic sometimes defies it. I mean, if you logically, if you think about it, that for everything, that if you want more rain, you do homa. If you want more crop, you do homa. And if you want to make somebody to win, you do homa. So for young generation, intellectual thinking generation does not, they don't get convinced about that. So you have to do in such a way that they should convince and get convinced, and they should know where we are coming from. And we must take them to the temple at least once a month. And not only just to sit down and do all the chanting and everything, but just take them there. Let them spend their time, let them watch what other people are doing, and I'm sure from that they will learn something out of it.
I think you have a very pragmatic approach, because there are areas which are difficult to comprehend until unless you follow, you do some practices, you may not. And it requires some additional intellectual exercise to be able to appreciate why Homa and rain are interrelated. We may not have that much of time as parents ourselves, probably. So it is good, whichever way it works. But let's look at Indian culture, not just from religious point of view, but overall, how you relate to others is also a part of Indian culture.
Yes, of course. How you relate to others, how you respect others, how you behave with others is very important, and that's part of our Indian culture, and that we should instill into our young generation.
And we recently had many functions dedicated to Mahatma Gandhi ji, and we always talk about environmental consciousness. That also comes from Indian culture, and especially we have had the tradition of worshipping trees, and there were communities who sacrificed. So how do you see, on account of, because this goes with understanding of science also.
Well, I mean, it's very important because I mean, the planting of the trees or make the things very clean. But again, all these things are very important. But it's less relevant here in Western countries because basically these educations they have right from the school. So it's not like back home. On the contrary, we have to make more effort to explain to people that, you know, we all clean our in the morning. We do puja to Tulsi and we clean our front yard. But then the whole thing we drop into the next door neighbor's front yard. So that we have to change. And that philosophy we have to change.
Mm. Talking about macro level, the Delhi smoke is a cause of concern for Delhiites. They made students stay home because it was not healthy.
Yeah, the smoke is very, very unhealthy. I mean, the level of the pollution is almost 500, which is almost like smoking 20 cigarettes per day. And so it's very damaging to the health. And I think I would dare to say that all the political parties are responsible for that, because it's very easy to cure, because we know that most of that pollution is not only coming from the cars and vehicles. Part of it is coming from car and vehicle, but most of them coming from the burning of the crop in a neighboring state. And why government cannot, when we are talking about going to the moon rocket, I mean in the space, why we cannot? There is instruments available to take care of those crop without burning them or burning them in a certain fashion. So that government should invest money into that kind of thing. So this every year this problem comes, which should not happen.
Absolutely. What you said is what was mentioned by Chief Minister of Delhi, Arvind Kejriwalji, and then people criticize him that you are putting blame on the other state and you are not doing what you can do. But it is a cumulative effect of many, many factors.
Yeah, it's many factors, yes. But I mean, nobody is doing anything about it. And that's unfortunate part. And farmers will say that they cannot afford to do themselves because it's too expensive for them. So it has to be state-owned or state-operated mechanism or ability to do this thing where you don't need to burn the crop in the open air.
So one is each individual is responsible, another is political parties are responsible. In this case, when the situation has grown to this huge proportion, a common man feels that what can he do? But do you see there is a potentially positive role that every citizen can play, or?
Yeah, I mean, there is a positive role every citizen can play. I mean, they can use their cars and vehicles less. They can use less diesel as compared to the petrol, and they can also make sure that those who are farmers and who are well-to-do farmers make sure that they don't burn, because it's cheaper to burn the things in the open air. They should not do it, and if they do it, they should be punished.
Absolutely. And now moving towards another reference coming from Delhi, which is catching a lot of news headlines. It relates to a clash between police personnel and lawyers, which is unfortunate, and we won't get into all the details. But the moment which triggered it, that I would like you to address as a person who looks at the possibility of finding harmony in any situation. So this situation was dispute started because of difference related to parking, and a policeman misbehaved with a lawyer, but that kind of grew manifold. So not going into the problem, but just how one should work on one's mind that you do not have these kind of impulsive reactions. What way you have observed.
Yeah, so I think both police force as well as lawyers, both groups are professional groups, and they have their certain duties and certain don'ts and do's and don'ts. It means they cannot cross that line that easily. And so they have to be very more responsible, both side I'm talking about. And if some one side started doing something wrong, then somebody has to intervene, third party, meaning government of a day should intervene and investigate that thing. What happened? Why it happened? Because if protesters are very peaceful, and why the firing happened? So whose order it happened? So those are the things one should look into that, and it should not happen because it looks gives very bad optics that if police men or women has to protest, it means who is going to take care of country?
Absolutely. So who is going to take care of the country is a question which needs to be addressed by one and all. And authorities have addressed it. There are steps that has already been taken. But for now, as we move towards concluding part of today's conversation, Dr. Saab, your words for our viewers.
Well, I mean, dear friends, it is very nice that you joined us in this episode of this week during this Diwali festivity. Please, the message from the Diwali festivity is to help others and always be kind to others and respectful to others. And once you are respectful, then you will get respect too, and earn the respect by giving the respect. And hopefully you will join us again next week. Till then, goodbye, Jai Hind. God bless America. God bless India. Thank you.
And now, time for weekly show with a passionate India lover, chairman of ITV Gold and Parikh Worldwide Media. Get ready for loving sharing from physician, philanthropist, publisher, and India advocate in this week with Padma Shri, Dr. Sudhir Parikh.